Hi friends, on the topic active and passive voice, I have made three videos into three parts. It is a complete video when you watch the three parts. Now you are watching part three or video three. Now I'm going to write for the table for the modals. Now what are these modals? Can, could, should, would. Okay, here I'll write the modals. This is for the modals. Here I'll write the active voice and here I'll write the passive voice. The first one, Ram will write a letter. A letter will be written by Ram. Here we use be for all the modals. Next, Sheila would write a letter. Here we say a letter would be written by Sheila. Next we'll write, Radha shall write a letter. A letter should be written by Radha. Next we have, Mohan can write a letter. A letter could be written by Mohan. We could write letters. Letters could be written by us. Next we have, she may write a letter. A letter may be written by her. They might write a letter. A letter might be written by them. Next we have, you ought to write a letter. A letter ought to be written by you. Then we have, Bhaskar needs to write a letter. A letter needs to be written by Bhaskar. So here we see, for all the modals we use the verb be. Okay, so whatever the modal may be, we use in English grammar, all these will, would, shall, can, could are called modals. For modals, we use the be along with the modals. So I'll just read the sentences for you. Ram will write a letter. A letter will be written by Ram. Sheila would write a letter. A letter would be written by Sheila. Radha shall write a letter. A letter should be written by Radha. Mohan can write a letter. A letter could be written by Mohan. Then we have, we could write letters. Letters could be written by us. She may write a letter. A letter may be written by her. They might write a letter. A letter might be written by them. You ought to write a letter. A letter ought to be written by you. Bhaskar needs to write a letter. A letter needs to be written by Bhaskar. Now I'm going to give you some practice sentences, and that will be able to give you a more clear picture. Here I'll write practice sentences. Sentences to change active to passive. Again, we'll write a table. We'll make it into two parts. Here we'll say active, and here we'll write the passive. Active voice, and here we'll write the passive voice. For these practice sentences also, I'm giving you some examples. For the first one, he writes a letter. A letter is written by him. Next one we have, he speaks the truth. Here we say, the truth is spoken by him. Let's go to the next one. They did the work. The work was done by them. Next, she made a mistake. Here we say, a mistake was made by her. Next, she sang a song. A song was sung by her. Next one, he sells sugar. Sugar is sold by him. Okay. He threw stones at his shop. Till here, you don't have any problem because we only have one object, a letter, the truth, the work, a mistake, a song, sugar. But from here, we will be having, say, two objects or one object with a complement. He threw stones at his shop. Here we have, here what is the tense? Subject plus past tense verb plus object. This is the first object and this is as at his shop is the complement or the second object. Now how are we going to stone? We'll take the first object, stones. Since this is through is a past tense verb, so what do we say for stones were plural? Stones were. The past participle of throw is thrown. Thrown. So what is the next one? By. By whom? By him. Where? At his shop. Okay. Stones were thrown by him at his shops. Next one. Lalita prepares food in the kitchen. Here again you see this is the first object. Subject plus present tense verb plus object. So what do we do over here? We take this as the subject. Food is, because food is uncountable noun, we consider as singular. Food is prepared, prepare, prepared, prepared. Where food is prepared by Lata, where in the kitchen. Okay, next. He lodged a complaint against her. Here again we see subject plus past tense verb plus object. So what we take here? A complaint. Since this is a past tense, we use was for singular. It says one complaint. A complaint was lodged by whom? By him. Against whom? Against her. A complaint was lodged by him against her. So in this way, I think you will be able to follow and change the active to passive voice. I'll just read the sentences for you. Just listen to the pronunciation and the accent. Active voice, passive voice. He writes a letter. A letter is written by him. He speaks the truth. The truth is spoken by him. They did the work. The work was done by them. She made a mistake. A mistake was made by her. She sang a song. A song was sung by her. He sells sugar. Sugar is sold by him. In all these sentences, we have only one object. Subject plus present tense verb plus object. Subject plus present tense verb plus object. Subject plus past tense verb plus object. Subject plus past tense verb plus object. Subject plus past tense verb plus object. Subject plus present tense verb plus object. Here we have more than one object or complement. Subject plus past tense verb plus object plus complement. Subject plus present tense verb plus object plus complement. Subject plus past tense verb plus object plus complement. So here you see some changes over there. In this way, you keep on practicing, you're definitely going to easily change the active to passive, and you can write it easily.
Friends, you may subscribe to my channel in YouTube. To subscribe, please press here. Follow me on Twitter by clicking here. Want to follow me on Facebook? Click here to like my page.